Good morning, everyone. It is indeed my honor and privilege to stand here today on this great day in the greatest city in all the United States. I'm talking about none other than the great city of Mount Vernon. It's wonderful to see you all here, and of course we're here for a very special occasion. I thought it might be appropriate to quote just an excerpt from Maya Angelou's poem, which reads, "You may write me down in history with your bitter and twisted lies. You may trod me in the very dirt, but still, until today, I rise." We stand here today recognizing that the city of Mount Vernon has been, for a while now, been viewed somewhat in a negative light. And it's interesting because sometimes you have to go to the very low places in order to be able to see what you are capable of. And so I stand here with all of the elected officials, all of the government of the city of Mount Vernon and Westchester County, all of my clergy friends, all of you who have come here to witness this momentous occasion, this day where we break ground and recognize that today, despite what you may have heard, despite what you may think, today, Mount Vernon rise. Amen.
Indeed, thank you so much, Reverend Marriott. At this time, we'll invite the Reverend Jeffrey R. Wheeler as he'll open up for us in prayer.
Let us pray. Father God, we thank you for this glorious day. Thank you, Lord, for your grace and your mercy. And God, as I stand here on this afternoon, I thank you for the fresh, fertile grounds of Mount Vernon. Thank you, God, for this awesome city, a city that's set apart to be different, a city that's set apart to be unique. Now, God, I pray for our government, for our county, and for our city. We ask your blessings like never before. God, we pray that you show us how to be the best stewards over what you have blessed us with. Now, God, like never before, touch this area so that our young people might be protected and safe. Bless these grounds, God, that no danger will ever come here, but it will be a place of blessings. We honor you and we glorify your name. In Jesus we say amen.
Amen. Thank you very much, Pastor. Ladies and gentlemen, this is indeed a great occasion that we're here to break ground on the memorial field at Mount Vernon. And so at this time, I would like you to put your hands together and welcome a young man who is now in the leading of Mount Vernon. Please welcome the Honorable Andrew Wallace as he comes in. Andrew.
Good morning, everybody. God's going to bless us with a better day to be doing this and moving our city forward. We've been stagnated for a long time, our children, our seniors, and even our other middle age and youth was denied this field for quite some time. And it's time to return it back to the people. So we're going to be doing a lot of things here also. As we cut the grass, we're going to set up a temporary field and walkway and path, so that while the construction continues to go on, that the people can still enjoy this field as they once was. Mount Vernon, I welcome you all, your loved ones, and everyone that's here to this groundbreaking at Memorial Field today. This day will go down as Mount Vernon's personal day, where we decided to take back our city into our own hands. I look out into the crowd, and my heart is full. I smile as I think of all the people, especially the children, that can finally enjoy the amenities that many of us standing here right now also got to do it in our youth. Stepping forward, Mount Vernon represents a lot of things to our city. For far too long, our community was denied access to this beloved stomping ground. For everyday citizens, the solution was simple. Just fix the park. For others, many others, history could not have been made unless they were part of it, and others tied into the fabric of this occasion today. They said it couldn't be done without them, or it won't be done at all. I'm a firm believer in bringing in new and exciting projects to our city, in and invigorating our economy. But how can we do it if we don't first take strong steps and measures to rebuild our confidence and our pride in our people and our city? For those concerned of the controversy that resounds this park and the city, I implore you not to be consumed by the falling leaves or overlook the strong and timeless standing tree here before you. As you see, all the elected officials are standing here because we all want the same thing. It's our community, it's our time. It's time to turn things around and take it into a whole new direction. The ship that was sailing in the wrong direction for so long has been turned around. This has been a long journey, and I'm honored to be the one to end the wait, to end the weight of officials that say they can't get things done, to end the weight of the wishes of our people that want their field back, to end the weight of stability in Mount Vernon. People of Mount Vernon, your patience has gone unnoticed or unappreciated, but standing here today tells you that the wait is over. This project reminds us of how far the city has come. Its current state reminds us of the things that Mount Vernon once was. The city riddled with mess, its growth sunned by controversy, and its beauty woefully inconceivable due to political blindness. For too long, it has served as a painful reminder of what was. The people of this city walk past and see memories. They look up and see the field and feel betrayed, where they once felt pride. I can say for myself, even personally, for a long time I've stood embarrassed and hurt. For me, I know that we can do better. We must do better. And for Mount Vernon, we can do better. And it starts today. Thank you for being here.
Come on, you can do better, even for the mayor, of course. Indeed, it is time to move the city forward and Memorial Field forward. Amen? Indeed. And this lady, I admire her for her tenacity, for her leadership, and for her humbleness. I would like you to put your hands together and welcome the Honorable Ruud Hassel Thompson, former state senator of New York. Come on, give her a big hand, please, as she comes.
Thank you. Good morning. 26 years ago in November, I was elected to the city council to the city of Mount Vernon. And one of the first controversial issues that came before that council was Memorial Field. There was a vote that was taken not to give this field to the county, but rather try to find a way to develop it so that it would continue to be a monument to those soldiers for whom the field was dedicated. Those have been 26 tumultuous years. We have had several different mayors. We've had several different ideas. And we've had many fights about what this field should be. The significance of this field indicates that it is the gateway into Mount Vernon from Pelham and from other parts south of this county. And so therefore, any decisions that is made about what should happen is more than a political decision, but it's an economic decision. It helps to determine the value of the homes of the families and people who live in this community. We forget that everything that we do is about the people, not our own personal aggrandizement. We've had 26 years to get it right. But what I'd like to believe that today is the birthing, after pain and suffering, to get it right. Today, that people will put aside their political ambitions and use their political will and resources to make this the hallmark of what Mount Vernon has stood for. I'm not one of those that believes that yesteryear was great, but I look forward to tomorrow being grand. I'm here today, and I took off this morning, and this program is a little bit of a misnomer. I'm not here to represent the governor. I'm here to represent me. I'm here to represent my commitment, third generation, raising two additional generations to this city. This field is about my grandson. I ran 7-minute miles when we had a track. I played tennis 4 days a week when we had a tennis court. My children, as infants, swung in the swings in the playground. 50 years later, my daughter is saying to me, Ma, what happened? What happened to our city? My 26-year-old granddaughter says, you talk about all the grandness of the football games that were played at Memorial Field. Well, we can't play anything in that Dust Bowl. But I told her this morning when she left for work, we were going to dig a hole today. And in that hole, we were going to sow seeds of the future and bury the hostilities of the past. So those of you who are with me and who are with this mayor, and I don't care if you don't like him, but he's here. And I've served under mayors I didn't like either. But I served the city and not the person. I respect the office, if not the individual. So today, I want you to embrace the office of the mayor of the city of Mount Vernon. Put your shoulder behind the wheel and make Memorial Field be a memorial of who the people of Mount Vernon can be.
Come on, give it up for, indeed, our former Senator Ruth. Give her a big hand, please, yes? It's all about Mount Vernon, indeed. I didn't introduce myself. My name is Reverend Patrick Tyson, and I'm a radio broadcaster on Unity Radio 96.1 FM. Mount Vernon is my home. Amen, and I love Mount Vernon, and so I'm here to support her as she rises from the ash. Amen? Amen? At this time, I'm going to invite a young man who I admire, who is a friend of mine. Please, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together and welcome Senator Jamal Bailey.
Well, you know what I'm doing, and not because I'm not happy about being here today. It was one thing to succeed a legend in the state senate. I had problems walking in. Well, you know, Ruth did it this way. You know, Ruth did it that way. You know, Ruth did this and Ruth did, yes, yes, yes. Senator Hassel Thompson, thank you for everything that you've done for not just the city of Mount Vernon, but for the Bronx. For that, you deserve a round of applause. And yes, when you see her in the streets, please call her Senator still, because she's deserving of that title. It's hard to follow not just the legend, but that speech, but I will try to do so as a Bronx boy. And as a Bronx boy, born and raised, yes, I want Memorial Field back to where it was. Yes, we in the Bronx use Memorial Field too. Yes, we used to come run on the track, and I didn't play tennis because I couldn't do it, but we used to use this field as well. And as a state senator, I do something called the senior walk, where I take seniors from different parts of my district, and in great palatial places such as Co-op City and the Williams Bridge Oval, we have seniors walk around tracks for their health, because if there's, they say health is wealth, you don't want to go bankrupt. I want to be able to do that here in the city of Mount Vernon. And regardless of anything, this is a start to something great. I see the dirt, and I try to teach my kids that from dirt, great things grow. And you might just see dirt here today, but something great is going to grow because of the people not just behind me, because of the people that are in front of me. Because of the 70,000 plus people in the greatest concentrated 4 square miles in New York State. Yes, I said it as a Bronx boy. Yes, I said it. And Senator Hassel Thompson said it to me too. She says, you're gonna find something about the city of Mount Vernon. I'm gonna paraphrase you here, Ruth. I don't wanna quote you directly, get in trouble for that. You're gonna find a resolve in the people in the 4 square miles of Mount Vernon. You're gonna find a certain tenacity in the people of the city of Mount Vernon. You're going to find something special in the city of Mount Vernon, and I certainly have. Throughout my 2.5 years here in the state senate, I certainly have, and today begins a new chapter. I wanna thank everybody here for their contributions past, present, and future most important. Ladies and gentlemen, we can no longer afford to simply have a revisionist history. The one thing we do not get back is time. My grandfather told me that a long time ago. So I'm not gonna look back. I'm looking forward to a great Mount Vernon where I can take two little Bronx girls to run track here one day. Thank you, God bless. Thank you, Mayor Wallace, all the council members, controller, everybody here. I wanna thank you personally. God bless.
Come on for Senator Bailey, amen. Indeed, powerful words there. We're gonna move on, of course. We're gonna call the acting city council president in the person of the Honorable Janice Duarte. Give her a big hand, please.
Good morning, everyone. I've invited my council member, Marcus Griffiths, to join me here at the podium. It is very exciting to finally be here for the cleanup of Memorial Field. It's time that we stop talking about it and we start doing it. This is a very exciting morning and a very exciting moment for this, for Memorial Field and for the city. I am eager to see the county finally step in and rebuild and renovate Memorial Field to what the city of Mount Vernon deserves it to be, the city and the county. Because as we are hearing, it's not just Mount Vernon, it's everyone surrounding us in the county, the Bronx. Memorial Field means a lot to all of us. I can only hope that the modified scope of work for this remediation will fully address the environmental liability so that the county can break ground in 2020. 2020 promises to be a very exciting year for Mount Vernon. As we move forward together, I want to thank my colleagues, all of my colleagues, past and my current colleagues and future, at all levels of government, not just in the city, at the county, and at the state, because they have all invested and contributed to the future of Memorial Field. And I look forward to working with all of them to bring back this great Memorial Field for the greatest city in the county of Westchester. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Madam Council President. There's a young man here who is always in Mount Vernon. He always visits every different activity. And I want you to put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome our county legislator, Mr. Lindell Williams. Yes. Come on, put your hands together for him.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you very much. Good morning, all.
Yeah, good morning. Good morning.
Now, isn't this a beautiful day?
Yes.
It's a beautiful day at Memorial Field.
Yes.
And I can tell you that I agree with our Senator Bailey. We cannot always spend our time looking in the rearview mirror. We have to spend our time looking forward and moving forward together. And I say that to say this. I'm the county legislator. I represent Mount Vernon proudly. I slept to meet a breakfast with mayors from throughout the county. And you get to see the county when you are a legislator. We have a program in the county called the Legacy Program. And what does that legacy program do? What it does, the county invests millions of dollars in open fields so that you can preserve the land, you can have young people participate in recreational activities, you can have seniors walking, and you can beautify the community in which you live. That's a county program. Now, it's different from the program that Senator Thompson mentioned about 26 years ago under the Republican County Executive O'Rourke, who tried to throw us, I was on the council at the time, I was one who voted against it, who tried to throw us $6 million, take over the field, and take us out. We said no. But we're under a new administration. We have a Democratic county executive. His name is George Latimer, who was born and raised in this city, who knows Memorial Field, who played here, who has been involved here, and he is prepared to invest in his hometown. And that's what's happening. The reality is, and I want to commend Acting Mayor Andre Wallace for taking on this first step of cleaning all of this material that you see was illegally dumped here. Because that material stands in the way of our future. That material stands in the way of Mount Vernon rising from the ashes and becoming a great city in Westchester County, which we ought to be. And I can tell you this, that the county is ready, willing, and able, prepared to invest substantial dollars, millions, into the field. In addition to my colleague, he's not here, Gary Pretlow, our assemblyman, who has done gotta put your hands together for him. Because he's a quiet guy, but he's effective. $5 million he has brought to the table for Memorial Field. So between the money that the county is gonna invest and that Gary has put together, you will see a beautiful facilities, and that entire facility, when completed by the county, will be turned back over to Mount Vernon for our residents to enjoy. Now that is progress. That is progress. We can talk progress, but to do progress, you have to have the resources behind you, and we have it. Thank you very much, and God bless you.
Thank you for our county legislator. Give him a big hand again, please, will you? Absolutely. And at this time, ladies and gentlemen, the brother who is coming to us next is one who makes a lot of great activity happens in Mount Vernon for our young people and for our seniors and just about everyone who lives in Mount Vernon. Put your hands together and welcome Commissioner Darren Morton. He is the Commissioner of the Recreation Department.
Thank you, Reverend Tyson. Today I stand here as Darren Morton, the certified park and recreation professional, not Darren Morton, the preacher. But I stand here also as Darren Morton, the lifelong resident of Mount Vernon. For now some 8 years, we have been working on moving this project forward. What you will find is at the end of all of the work that our children will be the benefactors of a great facility. A facility that will allow them not only to come and to play sports, but for them to find a place where they can build community, where they can learn from each other in their activities every day. To recreate life every day is what we want our children and our adults and our seniors to be able to do. They'll be able to play soccer, they'll be able to play football, they'll be able to play field hockey, they'll be able to play tennis, they'll be able to play other sports that allow them to interact with each other. But in addition to that, they will be able to enjoy the culture of Mount Vernon, the things that we have enjoyed on this very ground for decades. And also our children who graduate from college will have the opportunity to come back again and say that they graduated in their own hometown because they have a facility to do so. What is important is that we finish this project. It is not most important about whose design got approved or who's working what and who did what. But at the end of the day, we want a facility that is going to stand time. At the end of the day, we want a facility that says to our children, our seniors, and our families that Mount Vernon's officials, elected, appointed, and those that are employed care about them. And so I'm excited today because we've been toiling for many years. We've been running around in circles for far too long. Now we have a target and we're going to reach it. So know this, that the Recreation Department, and as long as I stand as the commissioner, and who in God's name knows how long that will be, but I will continue to work on behalf of our children, on behalf of our seniors, on behalf of our families, that they will have environments where they can come together and know that this is a community that doesn't talk about it, but is about it. Have a good day.
Amen. He said he wasn't coming as a preacher, but the preacher came out because that's what he do best. Yes, amen. Indeed. Put your hands together one more time for Dr. Martin. Amen. Indeed. And there's another brother who is coming who is going to energize you, is going to inspire you because that's what he loves. Put your hands together and welcome James Coach Mack as he come from the Razorback. Make some noise.
Russell is giving honor to God because without him, this day would not be possible. Wow, I can say a lot. If anybody knows me, they know what I'm about. I'm about these kids in Mount Vernon. I've been a Razorback coach since 1994, something like that. I can tell the age, you know, that's bad. When we had Memorial Field, families got together, players got together. We didn't have all the mess that was going on in Mount Vernon when we had Memorial Field. I graduated on Memorial Field, Michael Jackson on Memorial Field, Black Evel Knievel on Memorial Field, DMZ on Memorial Field. I mean, we could go on and on and on. Mean Joe Green, I was in the, oh, see, we could go on and on. I'm not gonna stand here, I'm not no political person. Y'all know that from day one. I'm about these kids. We need Memorial Field. I've been off of Memorial Field since 2009. I remember the day they came back there and said, yo, you have to leave. We had to put six teams at Brush Park to practice football, a baseball field. Okay, that's all said and done. We did what we had to do. We've been winning championships, all that. Everywhere we go in Mount Vernon. That's it. Our football is Mount Vernon. What I'm trying to say, we're talking about it. We're at the point where they say it's gonna happen. Please, make it happen. Make it happen for these kids, if it's nobody else. I have a grandson. My grandson asks about Memorial Field because my son tells him about it. He says, Poppy, when will I get a chance to play at Memorial Field? I told him today, you might just have a chance to play on Memorial Field because they are actually trying to do something. To everybody that is, I appreciate it. I'm hoping that when it happens that we still could play on Memorial Field. And y'all know what I mean. Y'all know what I mean. They'll put it up there and be like, oh, well, you know, y'all can't play on this field because it's somebody else's. Nah, Razorback, this is our field. Mount Vernon High School football team, this is our field. Westchester Jets, this is our field. So please, whatever you have to do to make it happen, please make it happen for the Razorbacks and the kids of Mount Vernon. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Coach. It's gonna happen. It's going to happen, and I believe that. I'm a man of faith. I've been praying, and so God is going to make it happen. Is that all right? At this time, we're going to invite Dan Scully to come and give his remarks.
Thank you. Very excited to be here on this wonderful day. I really actually wasn't expecting to speak. I thought I just had to be a pretty face, but I failed that one, too. But first of all, I'd like to thank Mayor Wallace and the members of the City Council for awarding us this contract. I'd also like to thank Mark Ederer, who's the Commissioner of DPW, who worked very hard with us to make this project possible. I want you to know that when we first looked at this project, we do a lot of these types of projects all over the New York area, but we didn't really understand the impact that this project was going to have on this community. And after doing a little bit of research on my own and talking with the mayor and you know, seeing what this really means to this community, I have to tell you that Tully is very proud to be here, and we expect to give you one of the best jobs you've had. We're going to operate this job safely, and we're going to operate this job quickly. We're going to get you on your first step back to Memorial Field. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much, Dan, of course, for those great remarks. So this time, ladies and gentlemen, again, I would like you to put your hands together and welcome the mayor, the Honorable Andre Wallace, as he come back.
Once again, I just wanted to make it clear that Tully, this truck here with this gentleman is a very reputable company. I've seen them do environmental work because I'm in the contracting business. Never had the opportunity to work with them, but I've seen many, many things that they have done. And I'm proud that they are the ones to do this field because I know their work and I know it's gonna get done. And for people that may not understand how this works, just to make it simple, they're not taking out part of the dirt, some of the dirt, they're taking out all of the dirt, okay? Everything else will be tested. We will grade a temporary track here, and we will put some grass in this field so that the Razorbacks can come back home. So there is nothing that we can't do when we all come together. I even acknowledge our prior mayor, Richard Thomas, who is standing here with us, which I'm honored to have everybody here on one accord for the same vision, and not to talk about it, but to be about it and to get it done. So this is very, very important and a very landmark day for the city of Mount Vernon, because I not only know we can do it, and some others say that progress is coming and change is coming. Well, let me tell you something, change is already here. So let's get it done and let's get to work. Thank you.
All right, put your hands together one more time for the mayor. Indeed, you know, united we stand, divided we fall. And what the enemy meant for evil, God turned it around for good, amen? And so we have to come together, and as the county legislator said, put our past behind us and move forward. And it's good to see our former mayor here in the person of the Honorable Richard Thomas. Give him a big hand, please. Somebody give him a big hand. At this time, I'm going to invite my friend, my colleague in ministry. Put your hands together and welcome the Reverend Dr. Stephen Pogue as he brings this to a close, and then we're going to do the official digging of what the mayor will do next. Thank you.
Thank you. Before I do the closing prayer, I want to recognize from Councilman Engel's office, Tyree Woodson, Congressman Elliott. Yeah, I see Tyree Wilson, Sharifa Khan, our city marshal, our city council person, Roberta Puzo, our city clerk, George Brown, to all of our commissioners and deputy commissioners, to all of the clergy. We thank God for you being here on this great day. The Bible says in the book of Joel that as the children of Israel were going through a difficult time and were exiled from the land that God had given them, he began to speak to the prophet Joel. And he said to the prophet Joel, tell the people of Israel, tell the people of Mount Vernon, that I will restore the years that the locust and the cankerworm and the palmerworm has eaten and stolen from you, that I will restore the years. And this is a wonderful time that God is going to come and do restoration in this great, great city. We also recognize former councilperson James Jubilee. I did see him. There he is. God bless you, sir. Let us pray. Lord, you promise restoration. God, we thank you that you will do what you promised to do. So God, I pray in the name of Jesus that you would look over this city of Mount Vernon. Look over the elected officials, the commissioners, the deputy commissioners, and every citizen of this city. And God bless this city. We are standing right now at the crossroads, oh God. So let everybody around us know that Mount Vernon is about to be restored, that greater days are ahead for her. Let everybody around know that eye has not seen, ear has not heard, it has not yet even entered into the heart of man what God has prepared for the city of Mount Vernon. God, we thank you for what you're about to do. This is just the beginning of great things to come, and we give you glory in God's name. Amen.
Amen. Come on, give it up for Dr. Stephen Polk. And we're going to invite all the folks with your shovels and your hard hats. We're going to do the groundbreaking ceremony. Are you ready, Mount Vernon?
Sir, what is thing that represents the future? MSN future.
All right.
Things are changed. I said things are going to change. Future from God, and I'm still the same.
Let's get together and feel all right. Everybody sing it. Say one love. One love we say in Mount Vernon. All right, take it out from me, DJ Sean. Take it out from me, Sean. Yeah, Sean.
We are gonna speak the truth, yeah. El Babylon, them are gonna get executed, yeah. It's the king of fair.
Okay, after three, are we ready? We're going to do the official. Official. Mount Vernon, are you ready? Isn't it lovely? So we're going to count down after three. One, two,
three.
Put your hands together for all these elected officials. It is official. And we have break ground right here at Money Earning Mount Vernon. That's our name. Thank you very much, gentlemen. I'm going to ask the mayor to give his final remarks. Mayor Wallace. Sir, anything else you want to say?
Thank you all for coming out, and keep your eyes open. Don't worry about what you hear, but focus on what you're going to see. Because that's what's important. A lot of times you hear a lot of things, but when it comes down to it, it's not what it is. But just trust what your eyes show you. Because it's going to happen. Dirt is going to start flying out of here, and people are going to start enjoy Memorial Field once again very soon. So we'll keep you all posted on a day-to-day basis on what's happening. But as you walk by here at any given day, you will see a lot of activities going on inside this park.
Okay.
All right, so thank you so much. God bless for coming out. Okay. We love you all, and it's time to get this park back into the hands of the people.
Great.
Amen.
All right.
Okay, we need a group picture with all the groundbreakers. Please put your hat on. Put your hat back on. Hold on, Sean. Lower it for me, please. I need everyone to come back. We're going to have a group.